I've decided enough complaining about it. I'm just going to go ahead. We are going to commit and we're just going to go ahead and rack it up. We're going to be redoing the RAM layout in almost all of the machines. Now, we're going to be switching to Proxmox on all of the machines. So everything's going to be hypervised workloads from this point going forward, aside from the Unraid server. The Unraid server still going to probably be in the SC846 here. Single core performance can get really hammered during a dusting event. So I'm taking out the processors that are in there, which were the more energy efficient 2650 V2s, and I'm replacing them with these 2667 V2s. Much higher core speed on these. These are 3.3 base, and they go up to about 3.6 when you're looking at their all-core turbo. These are the 2697 V2s. These are actually going to be going into the T620, and these piles of SSDs are going to be going into some here, and also some into the R420. Now, when we look at what we're missing here, there's a couple things that I've got to get hooked up. So basically, the tape library has to get put back into production. It doesn't need to stay on most of the time. As a matter of fact, it doesn't need to stay on except for when I am doing a tape backup operation. But that is an important thing that every now and then you do have to do. And as a matter of fact, right now I am in this spot where I need to get some data off of the tapes. This is gonna go back inside. It's gonna actually be primarily audio video. The server that I'm gonna have on here is actually surprisingly the AMD 5950X. It's essentially server class material right there. 16 cores, 32 threads, really high core count. I'm gonna have to find a chassis for it that's more appropriate than what I've got now, but they do make four-year chassis that I can adapt to. Yeah, so sound off below. Let me know what you guys think about this. I'm gonna be doing some electrical work also, so I'll definitely clue you guys into the electrical work. So when I ran these two circuits here, this was kind of a temporary thing and I knew it, and so one of these is going to actually be a 30-amp circuit. And the wire that's actually ran down here for these is 10 gauge. So it's the orange Romex. So it is actually good to go for a 30 amp circuit. So I'm gonna get busy here. I'm gonna finish switching out the RAM, and I'm also gonna swap out the processors, a bunch of different SSDs inside here, and then we're gonna be off and going. So when you're taking out the nuts from a server rack, this is a great tool to have, links to this below. In a pinch, this can actually work out also. So I'm gonna use this one because it's a little bit more comfortable for your hand. So the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to rack up the KVM here. So let me just show you real quick here. When you look at where your placement's gonna be, if you have it just setting directly on top of the server underneath it, which is a handy trick in why you work from the bottom up, this'll actually not align. So you can't let this set here. But I wanted to show you two concepts really quick. We want to, on a 1U server, have one above and one below for the mounting nuts and the screws. And we're gonna do the same on the back side of it over there also. So I'm gonna actually pull this back out. Then we're gonna go ahead and mount these nuts. Then we're gonna put this back in and then put the screws in that tie it to these nuts. So somewhat inevitably, you're gonna end up with a giant box of just miscellaneous nuts, screws, bolts, just wild rack parts. If you get a pretty big bin, that's a good idea. And at least you can keep all the rack parts in that bin, barring further organization, which would be something that I've thought about but never actually done. These are 1030 seconds. And so this is gonna be a size that you want to have all of them be, and then you can grab all of the screws that are gonna match that. Make sure you test out the screws before you actually get over here so that you know that the screws you've got and the nuts you've got are gonna go together. All right, and so now the fun part, depending upon whether or not you've got a tool or not, bring them. Like this, and then pull them. So again, that's hooking at the bottom, sticking this up at the front, and then pulling and pushing. Got the KVM adjusted, and so we're gonna put in the extra supports. Slides all the way out, no problem. Opens up. This is actually a decent height for me. Gets it back in there. So I'm gonna go ahead and tighten it up because it looks like it's able to clear and I can see underneath it. So there's just a little tiny gap, which is what you want. And so if you have, especially like these super micros, they can kind of get front heavy and slide out. Now, I don't think it's a real huge possibility, but just general safety with a rack. You've got tie nuts here. You can see on this, we've got the tie locks, and underneath these front rails down here, we've got tie locks. So these are not gonna be able to slide out of that place. So that pretty much just leaves the Dell T620 that could possibly come careening out forward if there was some sort of an issue where the entirety of the rack was tilting forward like this. Maybe I get really drunk and decide to try to climb this. I would have to be really drunk though. So I don't think that that's very likely. I haven't been that drunk in a while, but you never know. But yeah, that's pretty much the only situation where you're gonna have this coming forward. Eventually, getting the ears for this that mount, that do lock in place, is something that I want to do. The next one that we're going to rack up is the R420. This uses the Dell A4 type rails. And so on this, it's going to give you kind of directions. And so we are four posts, because we've got one, two, three, four posts. And then we're going to actually have the front of it and the back of it. And this is a nice feature of all Dell rails, is that they have kind of an integrated smart latching system. So with these, you literally slide them in, pull from the back, come forward on the front, and give it a good push. All right, so let's talk about networking. So we've got the Dell switch that we're gonna be using. That's actually gonna go up at the top of the backside of this rack. And then you see that we've got kind of this raceway that we've got up here, kind of ghetto a little bit, honestly. So no doubt, this one, if you can get somebody to help you with, you'll feel a lot better about it if you haven't done it before, because you don't want to drop this on yourself. But basically just hold it on up, push it on up. Finger tighten the nuts. Got it. Okay, so there we go. We've now got our networking installed. Be sure to hit like and subscribe, and check out these videos for more information on your favorite crypto topics.